అందరికీ నమస్కారం. ఓన్లీ దాట్ మచ్ తెలుగు ఐ కెన్ స్పీక్. రెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ మై స్పీచ్ విల్ బి ఇన్ ఇంగ్లీష్. ఆనరబుల్ యంగ్ అండ్ డైనమిక్ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ శ్రీ జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డిజీ, ది ఆనరబుల్ మినిస్టర్ ఫర్ ఇండస్ట్రీస్ కామర్స్ అండ్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ టెక్నాలజీ శ్రీ గౌతమ్ రెడ్డిజీ, మెంబర్ ఆఫ్ పార్లమెంట్ శ్రీ బాలశౌరిజీ, ఆల్ అదర్ మినిస్టర్స్ అండ్ ఎమ్మెల్యేస్ ఆన్ ది డయాస్, చీఫ్ సెక్రటరీ, డిస్ట్రిక్ట్ కలెక్టర్, మై సెక్రటరీ, మై డీజీ అండ్ అదర్ ఆఫీసర్స్ ఆన్ ది డయాస్, డిగ్నిటరీస్ ఆఫ్ ది డయాస్, లేడీస్ అండ్ జెంటిల్మెన్, ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ మీడియా, ఐఎమ్ వెరీ గ్లాడ్ టు షేర్ దిస్ డయాస్ విత్ ద ఆనరబుల్ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ టుడే అట్ దిస్ ఇనాగ్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ ది న్యూ సిపెట్ సెంటర్ హియర్ ఇన్ విజయవాడ. At the very outset, I would like to thank the Honorable Chief Minister, the ministers and other officers of the state government, and my secretary, my DG, and other officers of my department for having cooperated to the best of their ability to dedicate this big institution today to the people of ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ ఇన్ పర్టికులర్ అండ్ టు ది హోల్ కంట్రీ ఇన్ టోటో. ప్రాక్టికల్లీ దిస్ ఈజ్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ది వండర్ఫుల్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ యాజ్ యూ నో. ఐ ఫీల్ వెరీ మచ్ ఎక్సైటెడ్ బై లుకింగ్ ది యంగ్స్టర్స్ హు ఆర్ హియర్, హు ఆర్ లుకింగ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ ఫర్ దేర్ ఇన్నోవేటివ్ ఐడియాస్ దే వాంట్ టు డెడికేట్ టు ది కంట్రీ, టు డెవలప్ ది కంట్రీ, to develop the area which they are opting. Practically, we are all fully aware of that India is the largest youth population in the world, with 65% of the youth population is below the age of 35 years. It is expected that another 173 million youth force will be added by 2025 to this workforce. Imagine what is the strength of our country. And practically, if we make use of the youth force, the human resources that the youth have with us, certainly our country will be the number one country in the world. And I hope that this is one area of concern that we need to give much importance, wherein the youths can give their strength, give their energy, give their innovative ideas, and make use of this whole area which they can be benefited. At the same time, the whole country will be benefited. Indian chemical industry is valued at $163 billion at present, and it is expected to grow at a healthy compound annual growth rate of about 9.3%, thereby by 2025 we may reach $304 billion. So this is an area where we got vast scope to have our activities. And practically our ministry is working hard that CPET should be there in each and every part of the country. At present we have 37 functional centers spread across the country, and 5 more centers we are going to set up in the near future. And we are going to dedicate another center there at Cochin by the end of this month, that is 31st of this month, we are going to dedicate to the country. And this is one center, Vijayawada is one of the great centers where we started in 2015. But today we were able to give a full-fledged with all infrastructure to the students who are studying here. Of course, here we are offering various postgraduate and diploma course in plastic technologies, in addition to skill development programs for unemployed and underprivileged youth of Andhra Pradesh state. This institute is also, this center has been providing technical services to various state government organizations like Andhra Pradesh Drinking Water Corporation, Andhra Pradesh Beautification and Urban Development institutions also. This institution is providing about quality education to about 1,500 students in plastic engineering and technology with the emphasis of skill development and job placements. In the line with the spirit of Startup India, I would also ask, I would like to see some good entrepreneurs with some good ideas coming out of these centers. I am really hopeful that the faculty members will strive hard in inculcating the habit of innovation and research in their students. Recently, I had visited to KFAIR, world's largest plastic exposition in Dusseldorf recently. I happened to see stalls of various companies of our country there in Dusseldorf, showcasing newer technologies and innovations in plastic sector. I believe that the future lies in research and development, which not only generates large value addition and prosperity, but can solve challenges to problems which are posing us today. For example, SHIPED should take a lead in finding innovative, cost-effective solutions to tackle plastic litter and waste. I should come up with an incentive-based model that can encourage use of recycling of plastics. Practically, plastic has become an integral part of our daily life, and every diverse use by us is being by plastic. Even our mobile phones, TVs, car, even a pen that we use is made of plastics. It is not plastic per se, but plastic pollution which is the main cause of concern. We have to face this challenge before us, and we should eliminate this pollution with our responsible consumption and recycling technologies. I am happy to announce that we are also setting up a dedicated research and development center in Bangalore, which will be known as School for Advanced Research and Polymers. The new center is expected to give a new fillip to research and development in plastic by providing favorable environment and incentives to students interested in research and innovations. Recently, you might have seen Honorable Prime Minister had given a strong message to every Indian citizen when he picked up the plastic waste littered along the beach in Chennai a few days back. In our department, we are also taking various initiatives to contain plastic waste. One of the initiatives is the plan to establishing 4 waste management centers in different cities of the country. These waste management centers will use modern technologies for segregation and recycling of plastic waste. CPET is an institute has extended various technological support services to the companies in plastic sectors. Vijayawada, being a notable academic and industrial hub, provides an ideal location for CPET to explore the existing possibilities. I invite the local industries to utilize the capacity of the institute, which will start functioning at its full strength from this new campus. I am confident that the CPET Vijayawada will act as a catalyst for the growth of the industry in this region. My friend MP has placed several requests before me. Today we are going to have a detailed discussion with the Honorable Chief Minister and other ministers who are here with regard to the new initiatives that we are going to take here in Andhra Pradesh. one of the major initiatives we would like to take up is the CPCIR. We have got a port here. We have got all other facilities here. Only the area has to be developed so as to attract the investors from various parts of the world. I hope that certainly the young and energetic Chief Minister will give all sorts of basic infrastructure that is required for to have the CPCIR here, PCVIR here, and certainly we will take up this issue on priority. It is the vision of the Honorable Prime Minister that the newly formed states should develop, then only the country can develop. Even if one state, it is an underdeveloped state, then we can't call the country as a developed state. So this Andhra Pradesh is one of the premier states that will be taken care of by the central government in all the developmental activities. And certainly we will support the Chief Minister and his team of energetic ministers who are serving in this state. With these words, I once again thank the Honorable Chief Minister and his team and all the officials who have given their support and who have given. Honorable Chief Minister is asking to have one more CPET center here in Naidupet. Naidupet. Sir, certainly under Model 2, my department, my government is ready to provide a second CPET center to Andhra Pradesh. With all our support, certainly our youngsters will grow, thereby our youth strength will be the strength of the nation. Thank you one and all.